Hi everyone, welcome to You and Me Learn channel. In this channel, we continuously giving educational and entertainment related videos. So in this category, today we are going to see about the cable wire harness and its testing standards. So if you are working in an electrical wire harness manufacturing company or you are an electrical engineer, surely I am saying this video helpful to you, and don't forget to watch until end of the video. So before getting into the videos, if you want educational related and entertainment related videos, don't forget to subscribe this channel and don't forget to share this video. So if you like this video, just thumb up. Come on, let's go to the chapter. Before that, we have to know what is wire. We can simply say the wire is a path of energy from one end to another end, or wire is a single conductor, most commonly made up of the conducting materials like copper or aluminum. The picture of the wire shown below. And next one is, what is cable? A combination of two or more wires draped in one jacket is called as a cable. So cable can be classified into different types: LP cables, HV cables, core cables. So based on the diameter of the cable, so we going to decide the wire. If you are working in electrical wire harness manufacturing company, so you should know what is IPC and WHMA. IPC is nothing but Institute of Printed Circuits, is the standard organization for wire harness manufacturing, and WHMA is nothing, this is the Wire Harness Manufacturing Association. And next one is, what are the different type of tests you have to perform for cable? So to know the performance of the cable, so you have to do the continuous test, HIPOT test, dielectric breakdown test, and dielectric withstand test and IR test. Most probably many people are familiar with continuity test. So continuity test is used for a good connection and current should flow from one end to another end. This is a continuity test. And next one is, what is IPOT test? This is opposite to continuity test. So many people are not aware about the IPOT. IPOT is nothing but this is a high potential. This test mainly used for check the current withstand capability of the insulation of the cable. This is a HIPOT test. So here we checking the insulation withstand capability. And next one is, different between the continuity test and HIPOT test. See here, so simple different between continuity test and HIPOT test. Continuity test make sure the current flow easily from one point to another point through the strands. HIPOT test is the opposite to the continuity test. Make sure current does not flow between one point to another point through the insulation of the cable. This is a main difference between the continuity test and the insulation test. And move to next one. Why high voltage test required? So high voltage test mainly required for safety and quality of electrical circuit. This is a purely for safety and quality concern. So high voltage test is required. And next one is, what are the standard voltage level? If you are going to check the insulation withstand capability, so you have to apply voltage based on this rule. So for example, we are going to apply AC voltage. So the AC voltage equal to 2 into nominal voltage. Nominal voltage nothing but, so the voltage mentioned into the cable, plus 1000 voltage. We have to apply 2 into nominal voltage plus 1000 for AC, and DC equal to 2 into nominal, that's it. 2 into nominal voltage, don't apply extra 1000 voltage here. This is a standard voltage for to check the withstand capability of the cable. And next one is, what are the high voltage tests? What are the high voltage tests we are performing for cable? So we have commonly three high voltage tests. One is a dielectric breakdown test, another one is dielectric withstand test, and IR test. IR is nothing but insulation resistance test. And next one is, what is dielectric breakdown test? In this method, find the highest voltage of the cable insulation. Here we are going to check the highest voltage of the cable insulation. And next one is, what is dielectric withstand test? Here we are going to measure the voltage withstand of insulation with respect to time period. So depends upon the time period, so we are checking the voltage withstand capability of the insulation. And move to next one is insulation resistance test. So insulation resistance is mainly used for the coil. To know the quality of the product, so we can also say this as a maker test. So insulation resistance is used only for DC purpose. See here whenever we are going to apply 250 voltage to the particular DC voltage to the particular cable, so you have to get 0 mega ohm to 250 giga ohm. If we get this result, the product quality is very good. Thank you. I think surely this video helpful to you. So don't forget to share this video. So if you have any doubt, please comment. Thank you.